Hey everybody, this is Anthony from Stevie Snacks, and right now as I'm recording this, it's the day before Thanksgiving, and I feel very, very blessed to be able to do what I do and to have such great people to interact with on an everyday basis. So this video is kind of my way of showing that appreciation, and what I'm going to do is I created a little ballad backing track that's very similar to the While We Cry song by Kenny Wayne Shepherd, and I added a little twist on the chord progression. And I'm going to teach you how to play the basic chord progression, and then I'm going to create basically a 7.5 minute jam track where I take turns playing rhythm and lead so that you can kind of do the opposite of what I'm doing. When I'm playing rhythm, you can play lead, and then when I switch to lead, you can drop back and play. But first, let me say why I'm doing this. I'm very fortunate to be able to interact with people in a lot of different situations in a lot of different countries, actually. Every day via email, and lately I've been getting emails from some people, and there's a lot of people who are hurting right now, people who are unemployed, looking for jobs, not getting jobs, and it's just a hard time for a lot of folks. So I mean, if you've got a job and you've got family, that's a lot to be thankful for. And they always say that if you've got your health, you've got stuff to be thankful for. Well, some people, you know, even have health problems too. So the great thing about music is that it's a very socially acceptable way to let out some of that frustration. And I find that a song like this is a great way to kind of express things that might be inappropriate if said in other ways. So it's my hope that on this Thanksgiving, if you choose to download this over at Stevie Snacks and jam along with it, that it'll be a good way for you to express how you feel, whether things are going great for you right now, or whether you're hoping things are going to look up as we head into the holiday season. So anyway, that's just why I'm doing this video at this time of year. So let's get to looking at the chords, and then we'll get into the backing track jam portion of it. Now the chord progression is really, really simple. There's only four chords. The first one is an E flat chord, but I'm playing it as a partial G form chord up here. So 11th fret on the A string, and then 9th fret on the D, G, and B strings. And then I'm playing the low E open. Second chord is a B flat here at the 9th fret. Again, I'm tuned down half a step on all my strings. That's why a lot of these letters are flatted. You can play that with a standard grip or a the grip, as I taught in the Essential Technique series. So this is the one chord, basically, because we're in E flat, so that represents the first position in the scale. Then we're going to slide up here into a 6 minor chord. So that's at the 9th fret, and it's just like an E form bar chord, but minor. And then we're going to slide down to an A flat, which is our 4 chord. So if we don't do any hammer-ons or anything fancy, the basic progression would go like this. Now the nice thing about this is that it's very conducive to doing some more fancy rhythm playing. So when we're playing the opening chord, I usually start it with an open, then reverse rake into this. So go from the 9th to the 11th fret on the A string. Now right into that chord. And then any of these notes here, you can just hammer onto those as you slide into the. And when you're on this chord, one of the things that I like to do is a So you're holding the chord like this, or like this. So you can do the hammer-ons using the regular grip. I'm used to using them this way. So as you get to the top of the chord here, hammer on a whole step up on the E string, and then walk down, and then immediately circle back up with the hammer-on. And then as you slide up here, there's a couple things you can do. You can do a up to the 12th fret. And then because we're forming a minor chord here, we can do a lot of the same way that we do for the one chord, but the foundation of our chord is this minor chord. And then we drop to the four. Just do some hammer-on walk-up stuff. And then we start over. So that's how you can spice up the rhythm playing a little bit. That's just a few tips. Now we're going to get to the actual song portion of it. The way it's going to be structured is that I'm going to play the opening chord progression twice. Then I'm going to launch into a softer solo that's about five times through. Then I'm going to drop back and play rhythm. And so when you hear me drop back to play rhythm, that's your turn to solo. Then when you hear me, so your solo is going to be the exact same length as mine. It's going to be five times through. Then when you hear me on the last time through getting a little bit heavier with the rhythm, that means that I'm about to come in for the lead again. And so then the whole song kind of picks up a little bit. I'm going to solo real heavy for five or six times. Then it's going to be your turn. And so just watch out for my cues, because as we come to the end, I'm going to slow it down a little bit, and then I'm going to close it out by playing the rhythm again. So anyway, I hope this is enjoyable for you. You can play along with the video, but I'll also have an MP3 of the jam portion on this lessons page in the free lessons section at Stevie Snacks. So hope you enjoy it.